In 2014, when the Indianapolis Colts decided to hang a banner after losing by 38 points in the AFC Championship, a lot of people were shocked. It was not seen as an achievement worth commemorating. But personally, I wasn't that surprised. At the time, Lucas Oil Stadium was already near another memorial to losers, specifically the Confederate Soldiers and Sailors Monument, a 35-foot statue dedicated to Confederate POWs located in the city's oldest public park. Obviously, these statues are not just an Indianapolis issue, they're an American one. Fortunately, many Americans are beginning to understand why these monuments should be taken down. But something I want to make clear is that not every memorial has to be a 21-foot statue of Robert E. Lee to be racist. They're often a lot more subtle than that. In fact, some are still being built, and it's likely you visited one today without even realizing it. What am I talking about exactly? Highways. For over half a century, highways have been one of the most effective tools used to uphold systemic racism, all under the guise of urban renewal, or as James Baldwin would put it,
it means Negro removal. That is what it means.
Because when they're not literally built over the homes and businesses of people of color, they're separating them from central business districts. Just look at what they did to Rochester! What is this loop for? And this isn't just an economics issue, it's a health issue as well. Thankfully, Rochester, as well as other cities, are finally doing something about this, with the current administration seeming intent on righting these past wrongs. Not that that's stopping South Carolina. Come on, guys, you're not even hiding it at this point. Oh well, I guess you guys have more pressing issues, like making sure kids aren't exposed to the horrors of critical race theory. Ooh! But sure, it's not like they'll be kicked out on the streets, they'll be fairly compensated. Not for those who don't own their homes, and even for those who do, they'll be lucky to get a fair appraisal. To make this even more frustrating, widening this freeway isn't even going to help alleviate traffic. It'll likely just make it worse. If South Carolina really wanted to fix this issue, they should just make public transportation more accessible. South Korea did that, while also tearing down a major freeway, and it worked out really well. Especially for then-mayor, Lee Myung-bak, who became president only 5 years later. You're taking notes, Pete? Awesome. Just try not to copy the corruption part.